everybody, this is Aditi once again on Inner World Reveal. So we did a lot of numerology. We learned about the number vibrations, we learned about how to calculate the important numerology numbers, we learned about how you can analyze a person's chart from this data. So in this log, the topic which we are going to discuss is one of the most sought after topics in numerology, and that is numerology relationship analysis or compatibilities. I had been really thinking very deep upon the subject because this is a very sensitive subject, and you cannot just judge one or two numbers, and if they are not compatible, you just strike off the relationship. These are the matters of heart, and they really need to be dealt with a lot of care. So you really need to dig deeper and judge correct. When we fall in love with people, we do not calculate all their numbers and generate their numerology chart and then fall in love. Love just happens. So there obviously exists a person with the perfect number match with us. But what are the chances of finding that perfect person? Very bleak. So the first thing that we must accept is that life is full of imperfections. And to understand the imperfections, we need to first identify them. Sometimes we spend our whole lives not knowing where the problem is. Numerology helps us to locate the problem. Once you know the problem, you can fix it. Now on the screen, you can see the numbers in three rows: 157, 248, and 369. These are the numbers that quickly, effortlessly, and just naturally match with each other. Next, you can see a list of compatible numbers. This list is not serially numbered from 1 to 9, it's numbered in the natural match order, that is 157, 248, and 369, as you can see. In case you got a master number, reduce it to a single digit, like 11 into a 2, 22 into a 4, and so on. Compatible numbers, as the name suggests, are the numbers that are compatible with each other. So 1 is compatible with 39, 5 is compatible with 3 and 9, 7 with 4, 2 with 3 and 6, and so on. Now on the screen you have a list again of numbers 1 to 9. 3 and 6 do not feature in this list because 3 and 6 do not have a neutral match. This list shows numbers which can be neutral with each other or can also be good or bad. Relationships with these numbers can go either way. So 1 with 8 can be good, bad, or neutral. 2 with 9 can also be good, bad, or neutral, and so on. Now we have the list of toxic numbers. The relationship between toxic numbers is generally known to be very challenging and can call for a lot of compromise. As you can see in the list, 1 is toxic with 2, 4, and 6, 5 again with 2, 4, and 6, 7 with 2, 3, 6, and 8, and so on. Now the 10,000 times repeated list once again, list of the important numerology numbers. So we have the life path number, which is the most important numerology number. Then we have the birthday number, the name number, the soul urge, personality, and the attitude numbers. Now why do I present this list? It's because you need to find out all these numbers for yourselves and all these numbers for your partners and then do the matchmaking. So now it is time for a real life relationship analysis. Let us find out about a long lasting celebrity marriage and what do their numbers say. So we have Tom Hanks and Rita Wilson with their individual data. So let us have a closer look into their numbers first. So Tom Hanks is born on the 9th of July 1956. He's a birthday 9, life path 1, attitude 7, and these are the numbers that we generate from his birthday. And if you want to know how to calculate these numbers, you have to click on the link that will take you to my log where I explain the calculations and importance of these important numerology numbers. Tom Hanks has a name 11, and for matchmaking purpose, we always reduce a master number into a single digit number, so we consider this 11 to be a 2. He's a soul urge 7, personality 4, and an attitude 7. Now let's have a look at Rita Wilson's numbers. Okay, so she is born on 26th of October 1956, so that makes her a birthday 8, life path 3, and she's a soul urge 7, she's a name 5, personality 7, and an attitude 9. So these are the numbers.
Now that you already have the individual numbers of each of the people, so prepare a chart like this with four vertical columns. Write the names at the top as shown in the picture. Now, put the numbers that we have derived in order. Now, if you remember that previously we went through charts with compatible numbers, natural match numbers, neutral numbers, and toxic numbers. So from there, just find out the result and write it down. So this is how it's going to look like. So this is what we find. Life path numbers 1 and 3 are compatible. Birthday numbers are toxic. Name numbers are toxic. So large numbers is a very remarkable match out here. Both have a so large number 7. So that means both people have the deepest desires, which are very similar. So both people are going to get happiness from the same thing. So this is a very bright aspect of this particular chart. So personality numbers out here are compatible. Attitude numbers can be good, bad, or neutral, can go either way. So these are the compatibility results that we generate out here. If you come across matches where all the numbers are all natural match numbers, it's very rare, close to impossible. But if it happens, it's undoubtedly a heavenly match. If you come across most numbers which are compatible and are not toxic or challenged numbers, again, you have a great, brilliant and amazing match. But mostly, you would find 1, 2 or 3 toxic numbers. But does that mean that we must give up? Well, no. Because toxic numbers indicate challenges. They indicate where exactly the effort has to be put to make it work. Once again, I'm back with the same chart. So guys, this is a marriage that has lasted for more than 2 decades. But you can see it has toxic or challenge numbers also. So even this marriage has taken a lot of effort and a lot of understanding from both people. But is that all about matchmaking? No. If you remember, in my last few logs, I have been explaining that you must always study the combined effects of numbers. You must not just study few numbers, match them, and quickly jump into conclusions. You should see what the overall effect is like. The most important number for matchmaking purpose is the life path number. So Tom Hanks has a life path 1. And what are the natural matches to that? Yes, 5 and 7. Now, notice the strong presence of 5 and 7 in his partner's chart. Again, Rita Wilson is a life path 3. Natural matches to 3 are 6 and 9. So notice the presence of 9 in her partner's chart. So view the overall effect. You can come across a lot of charts with a lot of toxic numbers, but don't immediately reject. Find out if the natural match to the life path number has a strong presence in the partner's chart. Relationships are made in heaven, and every relationship is different and special. Sometimes they're just effortless, they just flow. But sometimes they need a lot of effort and a lot of understanding. We must find out where exactly the drawbacks are and where exactly to work upon. It just needs a deeper understanding. Many a times you'd see that we feel hurt, we feel misunderstood, we blame each other. But actually, it's no one's fault. So on that note, I would like to call it a day. If you liked watching the log, please click like below. And you can also subscribe to my channel to get updates on my latest upcoming video logs. You can also join my Facebook page. My next log is going to be upon numerology, house numbers. That's going to be a really interesting topic because you can find out about your house number and what it says about you and how it affects you. So that's going to be a very interesting topic and you should stay tuned for that. And you can mail me or message me in my Facebook page and I'll get back to you on that. And for the time being, thanks a lot for watching Inner World Revealed and have a nice day. We will be soon back with a lot more interesting stuff.